worked! It worked! Oh! 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 Oh!
Doc! What? I'm back! It's me, Marty!
It can't be! I sent you to the future!
Yes, but I'm back. Back from the future.
That's impossible!
You need to send me back to May 4th, 2000. I need to anchor for Chi-I Happenings. They need me. They really need me. Doc! Kevin, I got an idea.
I'm really sick of this desk.
Me too.
You've had to be behind it all year.
It cramps up the legs. My feet can't breathe.
I know. Let's get rid of it.
Let's get rid of this.
Look at this. All right.
That's the life. This is what I'm talking about right here.
Welcome to Chi Hi Wassa.
It's a show for students, by students, for students.
That's a little redundant, don't you think, Kevin?
Yes, it is, Josh.
Hey, you want to introduce a clip now?
Yes, I was just going to do that, actually.
Are you being sarcastic?
No!
Are you sure?
Yes!
For God's sake, here's Brian with a story on the Washington trip. Pathetic.
Well, alrighty then.
A couple weeks ago, Chi High's Political Science Club, headed by Mr. Frederick, went to Washington, D.C. for the Close Up Washington program. Over 200 students from 17 states across America participated in the program. They were split into groups of 20, called workshops. Each workshop was led by one program instructor. The program instructors acted as teachers and at times tour guides as Washington became a classroom as they visited the Capitol, allowing them to see how the government works firsthand. They had the chance to speak with administrators, reporters, policymakers, and other experts about what they do and where they stand on today's important issues. Some of the students were invited to a special seminar to ask questions to a panel of reporters and government officials, which was aired on C-SPAN. They were challenged to evaluate for themselves everything they saw and heard so they could develop their own ideas and opinions about the issues currently facing the nation. Along with learning about the government, they toured many of the Capitol's monuments and memorials. Throughout the week, the students met many new and interesting people. Many of them became such good friends that they made arrangements to keep in touch. Some of the students became very close. If you're interested in politics, have been or are enrolled in a political science class, and would like to take a fascinating trip, contact Mr. Frederick in room 220 for more details.
This has been Ryan Peterson reporting for Chi High Happenings.
You gonna graduate?
Me? Yeah, I'm planning on graduating.
That's good. You know, I got a story on what everyone's gonna miss after they graduate.
You have a story on people missing things? How can you make a story out of that?
It's gonna be like this. I'm gonna miss my friends when I grow up.
All right, let's just watch it.
Yeah, all right.
I'm gonna miss looking around and walking around in the halls.
Cool. I'm gonna miss saying the beautiful faces of all the ladies in our grade.
Breaking the rules.
Women.
I'm gonna miss all the screwing around we did.
I'm gonna miss all the homework I didn't do. And all the girls they didn't ask out.
But extracurricular activities I don't. I'll miss that.
We're gonna miss Doughboy.
You're gonna miss the little freshmen making out with their boyfriends in this hallway. The friends.
I will definitely miss Chi High Happenings the most.
I'm going to miss all of the fire alarms.
Walking around in the hallways.
Stay at
I'm gonna miss sports.
I'm just gonna miss all the people at school, and it's gonna be sad to leave. And
I'm gonna miss Nostalgia class and all the lovely teachers.
We're gonna miss Kevin pulling us out of our class.
I'm gonna miss Shelby Reno.
Yes, I'm definitely gonna be missing Shelby.
Shelby Reno. I'm gonna miss that.
I'm gonna miss being in sports and my friends.
I'm gonna miss hockey games.
I'm going to definitely miss my friends the most. I think that's the same for me too. I'm going to miss all my friends.
I'm Corey Evanson. I'm going to miss saying, "Look at me!"
Probably going to miss my soccer team the most and playing in soccer teams.
Friends and football games.
I guess I'm just gonna miss hanging out in the band room, because that's basically all I do this year. I have no real classes. I just kind of hang out. I'm gonna miss that.
Graduate. Mr. Blinkman's anatomy class. That's what I'm gonna miss most.
Skipping. I like to skip a lot. And college, usually have to go to classes and you don't get in trouble for skipping, so there's no thrill in it.
I'm gonna miss being with my friends and being, you know, having the feeling of belonging to a group, belonging to a schedule.
I'm gonna miss all my friends and basically all the good teachers that are here still.
I'm gonna miss my friends a lot, and I don't know, that's pretty much about it. Will we think about tomorrow like we think about now? Can we survive it out there? Can we make it somehow? I guess I thought that this would never end, and suddenly it's like the women and men. Will the past be a shadow that will follow us around? Will this memories fade when I leave this town?
Bonjour.
Bonjour, je suis Van Blanc, c'est le nom, Marseille.
Comment allez-vous?
Oh, oui, oui, monsieur.
French 4 and 5 are getting together next year. That's terrible. Here's Brandon with an editorial.
I am really sad about what's happening to our French classes.
Next year, French 4 and 5 classes are going to be combined into one class. The reason being because numbers of French students in lower level classes are up two sections.
I think it is wrong to try to get rid of classes that are growing in numbers, because our French 5 class is going to be larger than the previous one, and there are more classes in French this year than there have been before.
But since the higher levels of classes stay constant, this causes a problem for the staff. There are more periods of French than there are teachers.
I'm really mad that we're not going to have a French 5 maybe, or that it's going to be combined, because I think it'd be really hard to teach both classes at once. And I also think we deserve our French 5 since we've been in French so long. And I think the school needs to stop just ripping off programs that are expanding, and they need to keep expanding them so they don't get cut or grouped together like that. It's not good for the students.
This may be a direct result from the failure of the recent referendum. So in result of this, the plan might be to combine the French 4 and 5 classes into one. The only problem with this is that this idea just does not work. It would be difficult to cover as much material as in a one-section class. Everything is different in the two classes. The books, the videotapes, the audio tapes, everything. It would be very difficult for the students to learn as much material as in a normal class. This just plain and simply is just not fair for the French 4 and 5 students.
I mean, I'm thinking that the people who've been in it since 8th grade actually care about their French and deserve a class. I think they're entitled to a class.
These higher levels of classes have students who stay in the class because they like their class and work hard to get where they are, and they each deserve their own class.
Well, I think it's ripping us off. Our 4 years of hard work are just not going to be rewarded at the end.
When it gets to the point where two totally different classes are combined, where the students can barely learn, maybe the priority of where the school's funds are being spent should be taken into consideration. This has been Brian Walters reporting for Triad.
Hey, Kevin, did you see Beth this week?
Yeah, she's really sunburned.
Red as an apple.
It's red.
And asked her if this hurt. She said yes. Here's Beth with sunburn stories.
I asked her, this hurt, and she said, no, that hurt.
Well, it's summertime and the tans are out, but so are the burns. If you're a fair-skinned person like me, you've already got your burn. So I thought, I'd give a few tips to those of us who have problems with this situation. So here we go. Listen hard, because you may find these very, very helpful.
Let's all remember that the sun is a blazing ball of fire, but this doesn't mean we have to hide from it.
I'm melting!
The sun is meant to be enjoyed. Sunglasses are always key to keep the sun out of your eyes. But yet, the occasional hat may do the trick. If the hat comes with a personal fanner, that's a bonus. My favorite is the sunscreen. Don't be too skimpy on it. Remember, being red is not cool. No pun intended. If all else fails and you just want to be outside, find a nice shady spot to relax. Remember, the sun can be fun, but not if you're burnt. So take the necessary precautions. This has been Beth Stewart reporting for Chi High Happenings.
Hey, Kevin, did you see me last night on TV?
No, I didn't.
Yeah, I was on Cops.
Did you get arrested or something, or what?
No. But these people did.
Cops is filmed on location with the men and women of law enforcement. All suspects are innocent until proven guilty in a court of law.
You see, we're on a mission from God.
Yeah, I've been on the force for about 10 years. What can I say? There's a lot of crazy stuff that goes on, you know. It ranges from, rescuing cats from trees, drug busts, speeders, and then there's those kids, I like them and whatnot, but you know, sometimes they do some crazy things. What can I say?
Please report to the baseball field with report of kids selling drugs.
It's good. Well, it looks like we got our first call of the night. It seems that we got some, you know, kids selling drugs and whatnot. I don't know what the deal is with that. It's the money that draws them into it. It's kind of sad, really. What can I say? Yeah, in fact, here they are now. I don't know what they're up to. Let's just find out.
Yeah, something's going on.
Excuse me, guys. What's going on? Oh! Car here for about 5 minutes. They seem to be swerving. They're kind of, looks like they're a little drunk. Yeah, it looks like they shouldn't be driving on the road here. Just gonna wait for them to kind of corner themselves here. I don't want anybody to crash. I don't know what the deal is here. Just gonna, we'll pull them over here. Oh, okay, he's still going. Registration, please.
I don't have them. Can you hook me up?
Okay, I'm gonna need you to step out of the car.
Oh no. Ooh.
Okay. Would you please step out of the car?
Ow. Ow,
oh,
my knee.
Oh, excuse me, sir. Walk. Have you been drinking tonight?
You can't walk. No. Have you? Lord, man.
Stand right here. I'm just gonna look through your car here.
Oh, man. No.
Sir, I'm gonna need you to step out of the car.
Where?
Just out, right out there.
All right.
Just right outside the door, please.
All right. Whoa. Open door. Steve, come here.
Okay, I'm just gonna look through your car here.
Don't look under the visor.
Excuse me, officer.
No.
Okay, guys, do you care to explain what this is right here?
That would be baking
pepper.
Soda.
Pepper. I'm gonna have to take both of you downtown.
Oh,
back here!
Poor Phil.
That's it!
I'm only 14.
That's it, you're both going to jail!
You see me, man. Yeah. Where's that other guy? Oh, Jesus Christ, he's wasted out of his skull. Excuse me, sir, you're gonna go to jail tonight.
Nothing here, just a light pole!
I can't go to jail!
You're under arrest! What do you do? This light pole! This is trying to be a light pole!
I'm a light pole!
This is what happens.
Oh,
this
man!
This is what that crack cocaine will get you! Don't tape this! That's it.
Oh, I'm so drunk!
Now you're coming to jail.
Hey! Mouse! I'm in jail! Hey, I know that guy! What's up?
What's up?
Oh, man.
Night of partying gone wrong for these two.
Party!
Woo! This is what that dope will get you. Time in jail.
Charlie 11 responding to a disturbance at the corner of Wells and Williams as a residential call. I'm responding right now.
Excuse me, the bottom here, sir.
This guy is driving me nuts. For the past few weeks, all he does is walks around at night going, oh, yeah! Just like that. It's just, I'm gonna do something I don't want to have to think of.
All right.
He goes up to my little girls and he, says things.
What's been going on?
Past 2 weeks, it's been really bad. Before I'd be like every now and then, but.
Okay.
I mean, this is Tom.
Yeah.
Tom Schindler.
Okay.
You don't know what's going on.
14839.
You don't know, man.
46th Street. This is right down the road.
All right, guys, just step aside. I'm talking to you.
You don't know how lucky you are. You just don't know.
I mean, this isn't as bad as what it usually is.
This has to stop.
Excuse me, sir.
That the space people.
Excuse me, sir. Some kind of problem here?
The space people are trying to take my brain through my eyes.
Sir, okay.
That's why I gotta wear sunglasses.
Sir, okay, step over here, please.
They already stole my shoe and sock.
Sir.
I was almost next.
Sir.
You stole them. I lied to that man, have him arrested for stealing my clothes.
Sir, okay, please have you step over here.
No.
You seem to be a little anxious.
You can.
Sir, please get away.
I don't want you to touch me.
Could you please get step over here? Okay. This person seems to be a little senile. So what we do in this situation, either we get the tranquilizer gun or the phaser. So we're going to have to go back to the car now and we'll get the gun.
You're next. They're going to get you next.
Sir, you can't deal with the situation.
Sir, I'm handling it.
It's getting to a point where I think I can.
Sir, don't worry about it.
Sorry.
Sir.
Like that Goldberg guy, you're next! Roar!
You're charged up.
You have to always run from the alien!
Sir, can I please step over here?
They steal your brain!
Sir, we just want to talk.
You want to steal my brain!
Sir, I just want to talk to you.
You want to steal my brain, you brain stealer!
Sir, I just want to talk to you. Please, step over here.
He stole my shoe!
I'm sure we'll get your shoe back, sir.
I want him arrested for shoe stealing.
Sure, sorry. Sir, it's please, my, knock it off.
He's throwing my shoes at me.
All right, that's pretty much what we do with perpetrators like this. We'll call the state down here, and they'll take him into custody for a while. He'll be off for a good hour and a half. I love doing that. Oh, that kills me every time. All right.
Start again, go boy, life by life. I'm gonna
sure to watch us Thursdays at 6:30 on Public Access Channel 11, Fridays in your study hall, all day, Channel 68, and Saturday at 11 on Channel 11. And you know what? We're in Eau Claire, too. Whenever they play us.
Whenever that is.
But thanks for watching. It's been a really groovy time. We gotta go though, so
we're late for class. So yeah. We'll see you later. Bye.
Can we put the desk back?
Oh, we need the desk.
Nah. Right. Nah. Are you hungry?
Why, yes I am.
Well, that's good, because Missy has a story on proper food etiquette.
Does she, Kevin?
It's fast food etiquette.
Hey, Kevin!
Hey, Josh!
You messed up!
Woo!
Hey,
whoa. I gotta let you say
adult. Yeah,
you adult. I jumped the line.
Whoa!
Go ten.
One thing for the record, Raji told me to do cops
and
not the parking lot.
Look at me. Hey, look.
Fine, the cops bring in?
Well, no, it's the parking lottery. Even you should know how hard it is to find a spot.
No. Cops.
Cops now?
Yes. Oh, we just got...
That's football.
God. Let me just see that.
Cops. I was going somewhere with that, and then...
Woo! No, but these people did.
Oh, yeah! Great!
Right. Wow! Ah. We got bloopers up the... Yeah!
Oh, yeah, we got power. Now we need a tape.
You know what?
Here's Bill Aiken, main office.
You're late.
Yeah, there's Beth.
There's Beth.
Hey,
Beth.
That was... Woo! I can't believe that.
Oh, my God!
That's really cool. AP class.
Let's do this.
Duh boy. Why can't I say just duh boy?
What's the deal?